watching God's Word for You Today program, an online Bible teaching ministry of Maranatha Baptist Church, Villamonte, Bacolod City, Philippines. This program is designed to make the time-tested, solid Word of God relevant to your life's need today. God's Word for You Today is found in
"Say to them that are of a fearful heart, be strong. Fear not. Behold, your God will come with vengeance, even God with a recompense. He will come and save you. Fear not" is the series of our study, and I pray that this encouragement from God will be enough to strengthen us as we continue to face this COVID virus disease. It is called the silent enemy or the unseen enemy. Pero mga kauturan, hindi bagay nga dapat kahadlukan naton. Why? Our God says, fear not. And I tell you this, our God is greater than Satan. Our God is greater than COVID virus disease. Strengthen and increase your faith in God, for this is the only way to decrease and lessen your fear against COVID and anything that causes you to fear in this life. Para sa aton mga kauturan nga may mga emotional stresses, spiritual problems and struggles, please develop and increase your confidence in God. One of the ways, and the if not the only way, for you to be resolved with your stresses and problems. What is the background of Isaiah 35? Of course, chapter 34 and 35 is actually, or these two chapters are one section. The children of Israel is still fighting their enemies. And it comes to a point that the children of Israel were fearful enough to face their enemies. At this time, their enemy is their brother, Edom. Si Esau, utod ni Jacob, kapid ni Jacob, amuni ang ilang kaaway. It simply means that Edom is stronger than they are. It might be because that these people are looking at their capacity and not the ability that comes from God. We know the children of Israel failed in their confidence in God. They failed in their worship of God that Moses commanded them in the law. Moses encourages them in the law that they are not to depart from the God who saved them. But many of the people of Israel believed in other gods. So by that, nag-lower down ang ila spirituality, and long enough they realized that they are makaluluoy na in the face of their enemies. That is why they are called fearful, meaning dasig lang sa ila mapunaw, dasig lang sa ila mapirde, dasig lang sila malisang. Amo man na ang kadam-an ng mga tumuluo, kag maybe ayhan kung ikaw nagbatsyag sang kakugmat, kag kakulba because of COVID-19, you become fearful in yourself, something is wrong with you. But thank God, we have God's word for you today. Fear not. There are two things that I'm going to give you, principles to hold on in God's command, fear not. And I pray nga kamitan ni diri sa God's word for you today, maka-minister sa inyo mga tagipusoon, kag makahangkat sa inyo to increase your faith in God, for that is the only way to decrease your fear in this life. Again, the children of Israel possesses a fearful heart. Do you have a fearful heart this time? Napunaw ka bala because of the rising of positive cases of COVID in our time? This episode is good for you. And I pray that this passage, this verse, can help you increase your confidence in God. What are these two principles we can learn in this episode of Fear Not? Number one, siling ni Isaiah, siling sang Diyos kay Isaiah, nga hambalon ang mga katawan sang Israel, say to them that are of a fearful heart, be strong. Fear not. That is a command worth obeying. That is the first principle. A command worth obeying. It is God who tell Isaiah to tell the people of Israel to be strong. Amo man nang ihaboy ko sa imo subong. Napunaw ka because may cancer ka. Napunaw ka kay positive ka sa COVID. Napunaw ka kay na-diagnose ka sa cancer. Napunaw ka kay may problema imo creatinine. Napunaw ka kay damo lang problema naglabot sa imo. I encourage you. It is just God telling you and telling us in our condition today, be strong. May rason kita nga magpakabakod. Nganuman, our God is on His throne. Our God is still ruling and involving Himself with our affairs today. Makasiling ka daw, kadulom na sang akon, ginabatsya, ginako kakita sa Ginoo, puro na lang ko tulok sa akon kaugalingon, I'm so depressed, I'm so lonely, daw ako na lang ang gakabuhi diri sa kalibutan. Friend, please wake up. God tells you be strong. As God was with Moses and with Joshua and His people in the Old Testament and His people in the New Testament, He keeps on encouraging us, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world. As He is encouraging us, I will never leave you nor forsake you. This is the same God who tells the children of Israel, be strong. I believe with all my heart that this is the same God telling us today to fear not of everything that caused you to fear. Be strong. Our God who made us, our God who saved us, is the God who will sustain us in good times and even in bad times. I always would like to encourage you, Romans 8:28, all things work together for good to them that love God. Even the negative moments of our lives, God allowed it to happen to you for a purpose. So what you need to do is stop looking at yourself. Stop pitying about yourself. Start trusting God because He commanded us to be strong and fear not. This is a command worth obeying. Second, He said, behold your God. Your God will come with vengeance. Inyong mga kaaway, ginapigos mo, ginasuyaan mo, amuning ginahimo nila sa imo. Your God will come to you with vengeance and with a recompense. He will come and save you. What is that? Not only a command worth obeying, but there is a promise worth receiving. Our God will come and save us. Jesus came the first time to save us. We are waiting for His second coming to judge the world and to reward those who believe on Him. Gani mga kauturan, kung ikaw tuod nga anak sang Dios na COVID positive ka, may masakit ka nga deadly, I want you not to worry for yourself, but instead think of how God can work in and through you, through the kind of situation you are in right now, because He is encouraging us to fear not, and He promised us that He will be with us. Remember this, God is with you always. That is God's word for you today.